do checker jumps. So here is a way that you can do a checker jump. So, basically what you're going to be doing is I'm going to be adding another spawn location. So what I'm going to do with this one is first I am going to duplicate the spawn location and I am going to drag it towards the other side because I'm going to create another level. And just watch very carefully what I do. Now, what I'm going to do is I am going to be changing the spawn location color. So what I'm going to do is here in my edit menu, there is material and there's color. You don't have to click on the gray square right here. You can just click color where you see this arrow. And it brings up a lot of these colors. And what I'm going to choose is basically institutional white. Now, since I have a third spawn location, I'm going to need another checkpoint. So right here, I have teams. Here in Teams, these are my checkpoints. So what I need to do is basically I need to duplicate another checkpoint or I just need to add one in here. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and create a team, another team, and I'm going to rename it to level 2. And I'm going to change my team color to institutional white. So go ahead and duplicate your spawn location and make another team name. So basically we have a level 2 checkpoint and we have the spawn point right here. This is going to be our level 2. So I need to connect this spawn point to this level 2 team. So the way to do that is if you select spawn location and here in the properties menu, you're going to go ahead and scroll down and you're going to see teams. Now you don't need to do anything except change the team color, which is going to be institutional white, which matches my spawn location right here, my spawn location color. So if I play the game, here's what happens. I'm just gonna go through the motion. And to change my, change from level 1 start to level 1 to level 2. So my character goes through the motion of changing team names. So that's how you do it. When you are making team checkpoints for your levels, make sure, and this is a very, very helpful way, if I, whatever color that I make for my spawn location, since it is institutional white, as you can see right here, I match that with the team color here for my spawn location and for my team level 2 here. So make sure that whatever team colors that you are going to be using matches. Everything has to match for your checkpoints, all the colors for your teams and your spawn locations and the color of your spawn location must match. That's proper organization. The last thing I'm gonna show you guys is basically what Maxwell showed me, and that is a checker jumps. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to duplicate this platform one more time. And I'm going to move it to the other side. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move or duplicate another death block over here, and I'm going to resize it too. So basically, I could put this death block here, and what I can do is I can scale it and make it look like a checkerboard. So I can duplicate this and this. It might not be like the best checker jump, but I'll try my best. And yeah, that's good enough. So I'm gonna duplicate these a lot more. Might not be the best checkerboard, but hey, it's better than nothing. Now I'm going to play the game and see if it works. Anyway, I made it to the end. That's fine. So that's basically my checkerboard box. So I'm just going to go ahead and save my lesson, which I suggest you all do the same.
Be sure to join Tech Dev Academy's workshops and camps, and also read some great articles on their blog page.